But they haven't, I mean, they come to one or two meetings and say, well, you're not ready to build a trail, so let me know then. So I'm feeling that with the notices out on the Facebook page and some others, and I've also talked to a gentleman from the Boy Scouts in here, we may be able to get them to do some volunteer work as well. It says utilize legal counsel as needed. I understand the board is working on an ordinance regarding what you can and cannot do in that area. I would like to see that ordinance, review it, so I know exactly what I can and cannot do when we move forward with this in here. So when that's available, I'd like to be able to review that to make sure that I'm in, not doing anything the board does not want done. Like legal entity, Fruitland Township is a legal entity to accept any funds if we do go for grants or donations. Friends of Fruitland Trails is not able to accept that money. That would have to be something that we would have to work with the township. The William Jordan property, as far as the easement, he's an absentee owner. He lives up in Sheboygan. We would have to make contact with him. I could start out with certified mail to make sure we can actually touch base with him. I'm not sure exactly the age or anything of that gentleman at this point in here. As far as maintaining any actions, journal of any actions that we take in here, then we can do this independently or in conjunction with the board. And then who will maintain the trails once it's completed? Obviously, the Friends of Fruitland Township has vested interest in here. We would set up a volunteer network to where we could continue to do that and keep it maintained and cleaned off three or four times a year as needed in there. The page 11 just talks about trail building, just some information in there. Granular surface is what, that's a photo I took of both of these photos are actually from Anderson Woods. And the granular surface, that is a limestone base. And then the natural surface is what I'm looking for in the phase one and phase two areas in there. The bridges, we've talked about in here. I got a couple photos in here, but I've been doing some. It depends on how exotic you want to get with the bridge, how much you want to pay, or what your budget is in here. Because there's all kinds of bridges out there, and people will build them for you. You can build them yourself and like that. So there's a lot of possibilities in there, and that's something that comes to terms with once we get the funding and where we want to go with this. On the last page in there, I'm talking about signage in there. In the blue hash, that's a typical, this is a photo from the North Country Trail, which is the one that goes from New York out to North Dakota. Goes right up as far, as close as Lowell, Michigan, and on up through. Also, there's a kiosk in there. I would like to put a kiosk in next to the parking lot in the center in there, talking about the township trails and what are the possibilities in there. Make it a bulletin board. And in the far left, and there's a signage in there. I've already made a sign that I would like to hang at the entrance to the trail that here. And something I would like to see happen once you give me the okay to go build the trail. Cut down any trees. I mean, the only thing is maybe some small scrubs, like the little 3 or 4 footers or something like that, and like that. But all the large trees, I would leave them as points of interest, moving in and around and like that in there. But no, it's the garden type variety, breaking things back in there is how it's done. So It's not something you would do in American communities, so it takes.
So I'm noticing, just because I get that map up, but it's falling apart, it needs to be fixed, but it's got all the red lines on that map, and there are all the trails that are currently existing.
Mm-hmm.
That would any of those already be in existence on this, or would that be creating a newer?
I would incorporate them where it's appropriate.
Okay.
I would not totally abandon them.
Right.
But where, I mean, I'm looking for a nice walkway through the trees and stuff like that. And some of those are, you know, like the quads, and then snowmobiles are going down through, and some of those left over from the logging days.
Right.
And I'd rather see them just evaporate back away, back into, let Mother Nature take them over again, and build some trails that have some good view.
And that was kind of the path that we were leading down when we were looking at the Land Conservancy, was to keep it as natural as possible, but yet have good clear signage, and maybe a potential creek crossing at some point. I didn't know what would happen in my lifetime or my tenure here, but those were all things that we were going down, and then when we pulled back from that, we now are to the point where Terry has harped on us enough at our meetings to say, come on, come on, come on. We're still moving slow, but we are working on our ordinance. In our ordinance, I think we had in there limiting the hunting, whether it just be bull hunting in that northern section. We have phase one there right now.
Mm-hmm.
No ATV usage, no vehicular traffic. So a bicycle would not be included in that, correct?
That was still up in the air.
Still up in the air. Are you looking for bike trails in here or walking trails?
I'm open to it. I'm open to either one. I'm not fixing that. I'm not opposed to bikes, anything non-motorized.
Right. I think maybe that's how we had it, non-motorized, so a bike would work, as long as it had an engine on it.
That would be my preference, is non-motorized.
Okay.
Because, I mean, we've got a lot of opportunity for biking around there, and, I mean, biking would be, I think it would be an appropriate fix.
Well, I think phase one and phase two kind of fit into what we kind of talked about, being low-key, not a lot of cost expense at it right now, just because of, I mean, obviously we have, hopefully, the friends group to rely on, but that's not forever. It's only as good as the volunteers that you get.
Right.
But, because we're limited with our own staffing, with maintenance. I mean, there's no way that we can have him out there every day.
No.
Because we don't have, you know, without having a truck, we don't have a golf cart or anything that he could be. So it's gonna depend on, you know, some good community support.
Our friends Fruitland Trails Group, I think, will be able to keep that going in here.
And we also talked about the bridges as well.
Yes, we did talk about that when we were in the Land Conservancy talks about potential funding and grants and matching. And so I love one and two, three scares me a little bit, just because I think we're really truly pushing us to make a decision, but.
Yeah, no, I'm not.
Yes, it is. It gives us time to get our feet wet.
This is 2020, 2021, 2022. It's preliminary. It's not. I'm not saying I have to do it this time.
And we're currently, you know, in negotiations with the Parks and Recreation Commission, which we had support prior to this new board being elected. And there's some conversation that's happening right now on what is their jurisdiction versus what is township property jurisdiction. So we are in talks with that, and we'll hopefully get some clarification on that here later this meeting.
Okay.
So I'm just noticing with that one, it kind of probably averts maybe their upper corner if it comes through.
I don't know, is this the...
Well, what's in question is this lower area here on what is under their jurisdiction.
Okay.
So I have done extensive
research. Do I still have my friends?
No, I don't know. See where we go.
Just kidding.
Yes. No, it's all public property. It's just working through the partnership to make sure that public still has access to is what our main goal is. So thank you. I mean, you did a wonderful job. You kind of took kind of what we had in our, because you weren't part of our our ad hoc committee for the Land Conservancy, but you did a great job putting it all together and putting it into a time frame, which is one step further than we were back with that. So.
Great picture, David.
Thank you, Dave.
And love again. Thank you, love.